Well, there were tears of joy and anguish in Victoria today as its government became the latest state to offer a formal apology to those affected by forced adoptions. In the 1950s, 60s and 70s, up to 250,000 babies across the country were forcibly taken from their young unwed mothers. Some women were told the child had died, others were coerced or tied down.
We didn't know whether they were dead or alive.
I didn't know if she was loved or unloved or had, you know, someone to really look after her properly or not.
Today's apology offers hope to those separated generations with new legislation plans so that they may be able to find each other again. The federal government will make a similar apology in March. Well, here with us tonight is Leigh Hubbard, chair of VANISH, an organisation providing help to people who've been affected by adoption. Thanks very much for your time tonight, Mr. Hubbard.
Good evening, Hamish.
You are yourself someone that's been adopted in these sorts of scenarios. How important is it to you that apologies are made?
Well, I think for women and people who are adopted and indeed fathers around the country, it's an incredibly important step. It's a step towards healing. It's acknowledging that most of the mothers who were separated from children didn't do it willingly. And it's an acknowledgement to the community that these practices were wrong, not just by today's standards, but by the standards of the 50s and 60s.
I suppose that's the obvious next question. Does it change anything tangibly for these people?
It changes things in that they can hold their heads up. They can say, it wasn't our fault. Somebody else has said, a parliament has said, that really what was done to us was wrong.
Leigh, you were in Tasmania last week where you were in fact born and where an apology was made. Can you just articulate for us, for people that are not familiar with what you and many others have gone through, what it is that changes? What happens? What's the emotional reaction?
I think it's just that public recognition. When a Premier and an opposition leader get up in a state parliament and they say these things were wrong, even by the standards of the time, when people were not giving informed consent, they were often drugged, they weren't allowed to see their child, they came back to retrieve their child, when were told that the child had gone and been adopted when indeed it was probably still in the nursery. All of these things give affirmation to them and to their valid belief that they were very hard done by. Today, it wouldn't be heard of. Our social service departments would not allow it. Even kids that are adopted, it's open adoption where the biological parents are allowed to continue to play a role in the lives of those children. And so we have moved a long way as a community, and today was great recognition in Victoria, as it has been around the country, of the wrongs of the past.
Leigh Hubbard, thank you very much for your time tonight. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Hamish.